Welcome to the opening round of the UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup, live from the beautiful city of Cheongsong. Nestled among the Taebaek Mountains, the city is surrounded by national parks and adventurous activities. But Cheongsong is more than just a destination for thrill seekers. The city is also home to a number of cultural and historical attractions. With its stunning natural beauty and rich cultural heritage, Cheongsong is a place that has something for everyone. This season, we have three World Cups from Cheongsong, Champigny-en-Vanoise, and Sasse Bay over 3 weeks. So it's going to be a real test of the athletes' endurance as well as their skill on the day. Today, we'll be seeing some of the best ice climbers in the world compete in the lead discipline, where climbers attempt to scale a challenging route as quickly and efficiently as possible, while navigating through a series of set holds and clips using ice axes and crampons. The climbers are aiming for the top, but the routes have been set to be at the limit of their ability, so we can expect to see some slips, falls, and only a few tops. We have a fantastic lineup of competitors here today for the semi-final round, so the competition is sure to be fierce as climbers battle their way to the top. So, welcome to Cheongsong. How great is it to be back here after that three-year hiatus due to COVID? Cheongsong's been hosting World Cup tour stops since 2011. And in a moment, we're going to kick off with the men's and the women's semi-finals in lead difficulty. This is going to be a great couple of hours of excitement and drama. So just to tell you a little bit about the route, it's on the famous competition structure here from the Korean Alpine Federation. What a route it is. We've got, so for the women are going to be on the left, the men are going to be on the right. Women have 18 quick draws to clip, the men have 16. And as is usual, we've got 16 athletes, although the men, we had a tie in the qualifiers, so we've got 17 male athletes. So it'll probably be the men who kick off. In a moment, we'll go to the start lists and have a look at who they are. But just to get a sense of that route, it's going to be really, really exciting. And the vibe here, the atmosphere is just brilliant. Everyone is so excited to be here in Cheongsong, back competing here in Korea. First time in 3 years. As I said, that Korea has been able to host World Tour stop. So the weather here in Cheongsong, it has been rather warm lately. It's been 15 degrees a few days ago, which has not been ideal at all for the speed wall. But it's cooled down a little bit, seven degrees today. So a great temperature for an athlete's performance. Still not ideal for the ice, but the weather's supposed to get cooler again tomorrow. So we've been told that it will be fine, it will last. Also a bit of rain today, you might be able to see, but that won't dampen our spirits. So they're going to be a couple of minutes before we start. Route setters are just doing their final thing, making sure everything is ready and all set to go. Athletes are psyched. Are you psyched? Tell us in the comments. We'd love to hear your thoughts and where you're from. The time here in Cheongsong is 5 p.m., which is 9 o'clock in the morning in European time, which is pretty sociable. We've also got, of course, the speed finals coming up. That will be tomorrow. And of course, the finals themselves for leads. So just seeing a little bit of the action there going on behind the scenes. We should also use this time to do a big, massive shout out, really, to the Korean Alpine Federation. They worked desperately hard to make the competition happen last year. And it was looking good that it was going to happen, and it was really at the last minute that due to the national COVID situation it couldn't, and they've worked tremendously hard to make this contest happen and come back again this year. So it's really great to see it return. The Korean Alpine Federation also is one of the most popular stops for athletes. They actually have a fund for the top three ranked athletes of each country. And those athletes get a bit of budget towards travel costs. So it's a very popular stop. It's also a very popular stop because the route setters are really highly respected. They're some of the best around, also some of the best judges. They have really stringent tests to become a judge, so athletes know they're going to get a really fair run. And the route itself, the structure's been around for a while. It was rebuilt a few years ago, and in the last kind of couple of years, all the paneling has been redone. So athletes can really expect a great, great route. Just to tell you a little bit about the story from qualifiers. So we had 11 athletes from both male and female top. So we've got a randomized start list. And, you know, some might feel that maybe the route setting wasn't quite right, that so many athletes topped both routes. But, you know, I think the talking to some of the officials, it was also designed that way to give people the best chance possible. Now, looks like we're kicking off here. Difficult to see just who that is. It's probably Pyeongju Hwang. The men's semi-finals, the UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup here in Cheongsong have begun. Sit back and let's enjoy the action unfold. So he'll be given a head start before the women begin their route. So Hwang is one of the older climbers from Korea, 50 years old. Doesn't look it as he matches his tools there. Otherwise, not much competition record for him on the world tour, at least. Korea had a couple of contests in the last, there was one last weekend and one again in December. So he'll be part of the national team. They're fielding 31 athletes. They've certainly made use of their maximum allotted number of athletes they can field. Every country can field 6 athletes, except the host country, who can field 9 athletes per discipline. He's just holding that Stein pull comfortably with the right, reaches up with the left, so far looking pretty comfortable. Bit of a delicate reach there with the left. Looking very self-assured. Both men and women get 6 minutes, which isn't the longest time allowance. The longest time allowance in World Cup rules is 8 minutes. But not a lot of time to sit and rest. Got to keep moving. Hwang, at least he's on the scoreboard, gets that 8th quick draw. So as the first athlete out, you know, there are pros and cons to being first. There'll be some athletes who are quite like that. Limits the time sat in isolation with a very busy mind, getting nervous, wondering about the route. Here you just get on it, no time to worry. On the other hand, maybe there's pressure as well. You're the first out. But there is absolutely nothing to lose. So Huang was one of the few athletes who didn't top in qualifiers. And he drew with the Japanese athlete, Yutaka Shimada. He scored exactly the same amount of points. So he's now onto the ice. And get straight into that figure of four to stabilize his position. If you look on top, that's the red paint marks the boundary. He crosses that, it is disqualification. Ends the route. So you've got to stay within that blue zone. Those are pre-drilled holes, which does make life a lot easier. Sometimes you will see athletes doing their own. Tried to pull the rope through to make the next flip, quick draw. Sometimes that can be the hardest move itself. It's just looking like he's struggling a little bit. He's certainly losing a little bit of time. Gets that 10th draw. This is Pyeongju Hwang from Korea. First climber out in the semi-finals, the UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup here in Cheongsong. Seems like he's wasted a little bit of time on this ice barrel, but he finally gets over onto the next vertical barrel. Oh, and he's off. It looked like he was tiring. Now we're going to have a little bit of a wait as he's left his tool behind. So the first female should be Mina Kim. She's also a Korean athlete. Years old, making a fast start up the left-hand side of the structure. Gina Kim, she only topped one of her routes in qualification. We had a total of 11 athletes topping both routes. Not much info on Kim. Doesn't figure in the world tour scene in the past few years. But so far looking quite strong, leaning right back out to see. She's got that side hang there on a little just Sam hold, bit of rock on a disc. This matches with the hands, just changing position with those hands to optimize balance and stability. uses the hand there a little bit just to steady herself. Nothing to stop climbers using their hands. But it's quite a dangerous tactic because if you come off, you don't get the points. You only get the points with your tool. A little bit of a shake there with the right arm. Already, we can hear the shouts from below encouraging her on the first female semi-finalist going into the figure four quite early. Often you don't see athletes getting into that position until the terrain is really steep and overhanging. But if it helps, which it looks as though it has done, then there's nothing wrong with that. So goes for the next quick draw. She just doesn't seem to have total confidence. Unsure where she's going to place her hands. She's swapping hands between those first and second positions on the tool. She's going to change hands again. Going into another figure four. The reason athletes do that is it does stabilize your position, and it also can help you reach a little bit higher. Gets you a little bit higher in the hold, but so it's not super comfortable for Kim to be in that position. So she's gone for the second position in the left hand, holding the tool a little bit higher. Is it going to be enough to get that next hold? Yes, it is. Matches with the left. And now she steps right across the plywood. Gets that undercling with the right Stein pull. Named after the German beer, as in pulling a draft beer. That's what it's named after, the Stein. Very secure. It allows you to really reach up. She has done confidently into that side hang. Oh no, she's off. Just goes to show how unforgiving this sport can be. A little bit of pick wobble and it's a ping. But normally a side hang can be quite secure, but in the movement as she tried to reach that draw, she came off. She just changed her picks there from right to the left and then went back to the right. So, this is Yutuka Shimada from Japan, 42 years old. Now, he's been around for several years. Back in 2017, he was 24th here in Cheongsong. So he's already done well to make the semi-finals. So the scores come up for Gina Kim, and it's 7-17-0 is her score. But we are looking at the Japanese climber Yutuka Shimada. He's making easy work so far of these hanging ice barrels. We talked a little bit earlier about the pros and cons of being first out. In a sense, early on, you've got nothing to lose, but you've also got the benefit of being first on the ice. Now, if ice breaks, it's not a technical incident. Whereas if a plastic hold or a metal hold breaks, something wrong with it, that is a technical incident. But if the ice falls, that's hard luck. And of course, if you're going out first on these ice barrels, you have that advantage. If you're the last out, that will be Benjamin Bossard. The ice could be in a bit of a state. He's struggling here. Shimada to hang on, just lost his feet. Needs to get his feet either on the ice barrel or into a fig four, fig nine position. And the strength is waning. Can feel it. And he's off. Failed to recover from that. Just ran out of juice. Looking up in disbelief, trying to see what happened. One of the belayers undoes his figure of eight. Then we've got an ice axe, he's probably about to fall to the ground, which is why he's been, his tool is still in the ice. You can see the little poker, the stick has come out. You have to clear the area. So we've got our next female up. And this is Ross Reynolds from USA. She has 6 minutes to get as high as she can. Now, if you're new to the sport and you're climbing, the rule of the game, oh no, she's off. Oh, that must be so disappointing. It can happen to anyone. She's looking to start again. Now, normally, you're allowed to crack on in qualifiers, but not in a semi-final. That's it. And maybe she thought she could have another go. That's something you are permitted in the qualifications, but not in a semi-final. So that would be quite a bitter pill to swallow for Ros Reynolds. Very promising up-and-coming climber. But it has happened to the best athletes out there. There is not an athlete in the entire lineup who has not come off early at some point in their career. That is one of the main, that is part of the appeal, part of not the appeal, part of the game. It's part of the game. It happens to everyone. Sometimes it can be nerves, just a little bit tense, maybe a little bit fast, a little bit too eager at the start. Certainly she will be having a debrief with herself. She's at least smiling. Disappointing too, because it's a long way to come. She at least managed to top one of the routes in qualification. It's good to see her smiling. Sure, that's not the last we shall see of Ros Reynolds. She's an instructor at a climbing gym in Boulder, where a lot of the American climbers are based. Good dry tooling scene there. Trying to get that figure of eight undone. So no doubt we will see her again soon. Next up will be Sunyoung Park, who is a young athlete from Korea, 19 years old. But this is Yong Hong Kwei. Excuse me, Yong Hae Kwon. An absolute star athlete, and you can see why, with movement as smooth and efficient as that, making nice easy work of that opening vertical section of the men's route before it steepens and gets a bit overhanging. So Kwon has been around for a while, 49 years old and one of Korea's strongest climbers. He didn't win the national championships last weekend, came second. But he's got form on the world tour, and the last tour where Koreans could compete, he came third overall in 2020. International travel has been very difficult for Korean athletes. The country really only opened up properly last June. He would want to beat his performance here in 2020, where he came fourth, which is always one of the most disappointing places to be, just off the podium. We've got Sunyoung Park now on the women's route. She is just 19 years old, one of the rising talents of the Korean national team. She will be looking to make an impression here at the national stadium of Korea. The structure is actually only used for competition. There's some climbers feel that's a pity, because it's such a great venue. Really amazing wall. What is Kwon up to here? He's just taking his time. So important to keep that pick stable as you move through it. It's not like rock climbing where, you know, you've got your natural, you can have a little bit of movement in the hand as you rise up and stand up in the move. With dry tooling, that pick has got to stay at that precise angle, whether you're hanging off it or whether you're moving as you move up through the move. So gets that side pull with the right, floating under Kling. The head of the tool is not flush against the volume, and that makes it a little bit more challenging, just demanding a bit more on the core stability. That's something that Kwon won't have a problem with. Big reach there to get onto the barrels. Smoothly done. Now here's the masterclass as he traverses left, going from figure of four to the figure of nine, back to figure of four, and then take the tool off, matches the hand. Let's get the quick draw. It's quite an art form, delicate arm form to get it right, but once you've practiced these moves, they should come with second nature. And of course, these guys practice this all the time. Athletes are training 15, 20 hours a week. And many of the athletes have their own gyms, including Kwon. We can hear now Koreans, the fans, the spectators below, cheering on their teammate and countrymen. This high score he needs to beat is that of Pyeongju Hwang of 10.21. Yonghae Kwon moves into the figure of four as he starts in getting into the steeply overhanging section of the route. reaches high with the left, gets that side pull. This is always very delicate, very dangerous territory. It's very easy to just peel off here. Oh, so carefully he does it into that next hold. Now it goes into the reverse grip into a side pull. Reverse grip, very solid. Also uses your stronger back muscles. Now he's stepped up the tempo here. He's looking very strong, really looking through to make these moves quickly and efficiently. Conscious of the clock. Athletes get just 6 minutes. And you've got to get as high as possible. And that is his effort over for Yonghae Kwon. As soon as his results come up, we shall share those. Now, this looks like it might be Emmy Bertling. Looking. No, excuse me. It's Park Sung-yong, still battling away. Hanging on for dear life. Is she going to get herself back on the road? No. Well, we weren't able to see exactly how she got on her route, but it's a good sign that she managed to stay on the route until the clock ran down. And you can see a smile on her face, which is always a good sign. Exhaling there. Clearly out of breath. Are we going to get a little away from her, perhaps? Shaking out the arm. Really great, great effort there. And she just bows to some of the helpers, the supporters, the judges, the belayers. This, of course, couldn't happen without them. There we go. Good smile there from Mark. So I've received word that the scoring system is not updating. We are aware of this issue and we shall get it fixed as soon as possible. The direct website link for that is uiaa.results.info. And in theory, if you log on to there, you'll get the live results as they come through. So Park moves into the lead with that result, score of 10.21. So now this is Vivian Labaril about to begin her semi-final here in Cheongsong, the UIAA World Cup. She moves very quickly through those opening moves. Athletes always very keen just to get past that beginning part, get on the route proper, move swiftly and quickly through the first three moves, get on the scoreboard, but also to do it in a way that's just not a little bit too rushed. So Yonghae Kwon, just to update you on the men's, he moves into pole position on the leaderboard with a score of 14.28. So on the men, we're now looking at Masato Nakajima. This is his first time in the semis. He's got something to prove. When he last competed in 2020, he only came 34th. So he's obviously spent some of the COVID years in the climbing gym. His goal is to get into the final. Nice little move with the legs there. So, go gets that Stein with the right. Mentioned earlier, when you hold the axe upside down, the reverse grip, i.e. with your thumb pointing towards the handle, it's less demanding on your upper body strength. It uses the sort of bigger muscles around your back. Gives you a little bit of a break. So that looks like Vivian Labriel. She was just adjusting something with her boot there. She is working her way through the women's route of the semis. Also, you see her going for a Stein with the right, puts the tool in the mouth. Decides she wants to match with the left. Quite dangerous to match with both tools. All about getting, you've got to find that sweet spot. Usually there isn't space for two tools. Maybe it's just a case of just getting that right pick, just in exact right spot. She steps up. Now, you don't want to do this too many times because it is draining on the energy. She just gets her feet a little bit higher in the move. Can she do it? She's got it. Matches with the right hand, moves to the left a little bit further up the handle. So we're now back with Masato, Japanese climber, and back to Labriel. So Vivian, she was second last year in the World Championships in Satsfe. That is the result that she is most proud of in her whole career. And she's been around for around 10 years now. Also a stellar performer of the European Cup. And was third 3 years ago in 2020. So far, so good for Vivian Labriel. She says her strength is her creativity. So she suffers with her mental strength and getting that confidence in the head, which is so important in this game. It's all about staying in the moment. And she's working this roof section very competently through those Fig 4, Fig 9 sequence of moves into the ice barrel. Figure of 4 matches with the right, swaps over Fig 4. Fig 9 moves the tool, opting not to put it in her mouth, interestingly. Back with Masato, the Japanese athlete. First time in the semis. He says he likes the big moves. Now, is he yet starting to feel tired? This is the time when he starts to shout, Gamba. That's the Japanese really for just go, go, go. When the pump comes, that's what he says to himself. Allows himself a little shake of the left arm. Can't afford to spend too much time chilling on this ice block. As comfortable as it may seem, it looks like his time has run out and he needs to come down. Will it be enough to get into the finals? Well, let's see. Vivian is also off. Her time has run out. She allows herself a smile and a wave to the other competitors and spectators. Let's have a look at the scoreboard. She moves into the lead with that. 10.25, just four moves higher than Sun Yung Park. Whether that's enough to get her into the final, I'll have to wait and see. Remember that this is a randomized start list. Normally in STEMIs, you begin in reverse order according to your ranking. In other words, the person who qualified, who came out top in qualification will be last to start. And the person who qualified in last place, it was first to start. But that's not the case this time around. For both the women and the men, it's a randomized start order, simply because there's so many topped both routes. So who have we got here? This looks like the Iranian climber, Shabnam Asadi. She's having one last look at the route, working through the moves. Don't have long to do this. You've got 60 seconds before you start your route. And then your time starts the moment you both feet are off the ground and you get that first tool off the first hold. So Asadi is a 34-year-old climber from Iran. Of course, when we think of female Iranian climbers, many will be reminded of Elnaz Rekabi, who competed in the World Championships last year, the end of our last year in Korea, and there was a huge political furore. She competed without wearing her hijab. So it's worth remembering that these Iranian climbers demonstrating real courage and strength, not just in performing, but also in just taking part in sport. It's a political thing. So great to see Shabnam Asadi competing here in the semis. So we're now looking back at the men, and this is Tyler Kempney, a real rising star of the US team. He was fifth in SASFE last year at the World Championships, and also he won UIAA. So he's really come on in the last few years, because 2020 in Cheongsong, he didn't make the semis, came 19th. Just a quick correction in terms of the starting order. It's only the athletes who tied, who all got to the top, who are, it's randomized. Apologies about that. The starting order is in ranking order otherwise, until we get to those athletes who topped out in both routes. So we're looking at the Iranian climber Asadi here. She's been competing on the World Tour since 2016. And she was fifth in Cheongsong 3 years ago in the Asian Championships. Eighth in Kirov in 2019. She has competed in Europe as well, SASFE and Rabenstein back in 2017. Score she needs to beat is that of set by Vivian Labarille, 10.25. That is the high mark. Tyler hanging on by one arm. He's got his own gym, so he is an absolute beast of strength. He's also a coach. Hard climber and a hard trainer is how he describes himself. It's on that second ice barrel. This is where Japanese climber Masato came off. So Tyler topped only one of his routes in qualification. So the high point that he needs to get to is 14.28. That's the 14th draw. Still some way to go. Feet skidding a little bit. Hasn't got them into a solid position. Now he makes that figure of four. Still some way to get past Yunhei Kwon. Back to Asadi. Now she's starting to move into that roof to get onto that ice traverse. All about fig nine to fig four here. She's the fig nine there. Same leg, same arm. Changes the arm, moves into the figure four. Now to get onto the ice. Interesting where she's placing that tool. She looks completely upside down and she is off. Not sure she got her tool into the correct place there. Didn't work. This is Tyler, who also is now finished his route. Will it be enough to get into the finals? So that's a great performance there from Shabman Asadi from Iraq, 34-year-old climber. She will be hoping that is enough to see her into the final, but we won't know that until all the results are in. Only eight can go through. She's just looking at where she went wrong. She's just trying to perhaps get a bit of understanding on what went wrong. So the next female athlete will be the Korean star, Yoon Sun-shin. She really needs little introduction. Just watch her move so efficiently, so smoothly. You just tuned in. Welcome to a masterclass. One of the most highly ranked of all female athletes. Yoon Sun has a total of 10 World Tour stop wins. We'd probably have a lot more if she was allowed to compete in the last few years, what with COVID. and still very much the star Korean climber. So much experience, still looks like she's getting stronger every year. Just moves up there, moving very quickly through opening moves. Time saved now, it's time that you've got later on in the route. Don't want to be too quick though. You don't want to get too out of breath. You don't want to rush moves, because that's where mistakes happen, and it doesn't take much to ping off. So Yunsun topped in both routes in qualification. So from here on, the women is randomized starting list. Now we're looking at here, over on the men, Jaejun Lim, who is one of Korea's young climbers. Back to Yunsun Shin. Gets the draw. Changes her grip to reverse grip now to get that slightly hidden hold on the volume. This is where paying attention in observation period is so important. Athletes get several minutes to observe the route. That's it, otherwise on site. You can take notes. You can use binoculars, but you can't otherwise use any sort of recording equipment. You're basically taking this route blind. And that's really the difference, can make all the difference, because if you've got to know where to place that pick, where the hold is. Every hold normally has a little sweet spot, and you've got to know how to take it. Sometimes it's intuitive, sometimes it's experience, but a lot of the time it comes down to just really paying attention during that observation period and working out the exact sequence of moves. Of course, if you don't get it right, that's where you lose time. But Shin is making easy work of this route. So don't want to tempt fate, but it would be disappointing not to see her in the final. That would be a real upset. And that, of course, does bring additional pressures for her. But she's been competing 15 years, so she should at least be used to that pressure. Certainly seems so watching. Now we're back to Lim, the Korean young 18-year-old Korean athlete competing for the first time on the World Tour. Made a couple of attempts to get that disc hold. Not made any easier by the fact that Bollard is swinging. It matches with the left and goes into the figure of four and gets that next quick draw. He's doing well. He's looking good. Gets the Stein pull with the right. That upside down position of the tool. Ooh, just the head moved a little bit. That can be very dangerous. Reaches with the right, gets that hold. Left leg over the right arm, figure of four. It's a little bit higher in the move there. further up the axe. Athletes have three places to place your hands on the tool, first, second, and third position, and they all have their benefits. Obviously, when you're going for a long reach like this, you want to be at the bottom in the first position. Then when you're changing hands, it hasn't quite got the draw on the first attempt. That's where you can lose time. And some climbers do describe getting the quick draw as the hardest part of the move, especially if you don't get it the first time. The draw can be swinging. Just feels the hold there, looking for the sweet spot. And he doesn't get it with his left. He does well to hang on, Ed. Really well to hang on, but he can't make it. And he's off. You can really see it when the tiredness starts to seep in. He made a heroic effort to cling on there. Alas, not enough. A great performance there. Is Lim. So, Eunsun Shin. She moves into lead position there with that performance score of 13.29. The next female climber to go up will be Haruko Takuchi from Japan. And next male will be Luna Ladevant from France. Luna keeping us on our tenterhooks. That will be one to watch. And always expect great things from the Frenchman. He, of course, is the favorite going into this event. Now, big shout out. Here he comes. But it looks like Tristan. Just double check. No, it is Luna. It is Luna. He likes to start fast, really psyched. Give those arms a good shake to warm up. He was one of the 11 athletes top both routes in qualification. So pay close attention because he tends to move pretty quickly. One of his great strengths. Just knowing exactly where to place the pick, working through those moves so quickly. Luna is an incredibly strong athlete. Trains 25 to 30 hours a week, which is actually considerably longer than many athletes. We had a survey that went out and most are sort of in the kind of 10 to 15 hours a week. This seems to be almost double, and that's paying off for Ladevant. So here we have the Japanese climber, Haruko Takuchi. She's been around on the scene for a few years herself, 37 years old. And one of Japan's top-ranked climbers. Seventh last year in the World Championships in Sasebe. She got through to the finals there. We'll be hoping again she can get through to the finals again today. Just got to place in the top eight. So she topped both routes in the qualification. So we're back to Luna Ladevant. Still very young at 22 years old with a big career ahead of him. Just has a little bit of a look there just to see that the pick is correctly placed. Pulls through the rope onto the next barrel of ice. Effortlessly goes into figure of four. He's got a good placement with the left boot in the ice, which gives him the stability he needs to reach up and get that Sam hold. A little globule of rock on a disc. Gets the quick draw. Goes for the Stein. Just has a little bit of a play with it before weighting it, but he knows it's good. Now up with the right. Moves those feet. This really is a perfect demonstration of competition ice climbing technique here. Luna Ladevant. About halfway through clock. Not 100% sure where to place his pick on this hold. Can't afford to make any mistakes. He actually had a little bit of a disaster last time he was in Cheongsong 3 years ago. Came off and finished 13th, didn't make the finals. Which was the result he says that hurts the most. Would have been very disappointing having won Changchun at the opener of that 2020 season and then not to make the finals. So he is hoping not to make the same mistake again here. He's got a lot more experience, competition and real climbing experience as well since then. There's a lot of rock climbing with his brother Tristan. He also teamed up recently with Petra Klingler for the Red Bull Dual Ascent, which was a kind of novel format up a Swiss dam. And they made the finals of that. It's quite a fun film to watch if you haven't seen it on Red Bull's channels. So I've just been told that the Ladevant brothers, both Tristan and Luna, they're using borrowed kit because their luggage hasn't turned up. So that has got to be off-putting. And it just shows his experience and competence that despite the fact he's wearing someone else's boots, may not fit as well as he likes, he's looking at the top. Now, is he going to dyno it? He's crouching down, getting poised, goes for it. Oh, no! And he's off. That's a very surprising from Luna, just saying he's on someone else's tools. Maybe that was a factor. Maybe he just didn't have the grip. So disappointing for him, but it should be enough at least to get into the finals. Now, let's go back to the women. Now, this looks like it's still Takuchi. And she is off there. So Luna won't be happy that he failed to stick that dyno. Just see him hit here earlier in the route. Looked so confident up until this point. wasn't just able to hold it. Hopefully his kit will turn up before the finals tomorrow. Certainly he'll be hoping for that. You can also see the weather. It's really rough here, raining. There's a thank you to one of the judges. We of course should say a big shout out to all the judges and the belayers and all the volunteers. UIAA, the Asian arm of the UIAA Federation, who've put on this event, Korean Alpine Federation, all the volunteers and helpers who make this event so special. Certainly they're delighted to be able to host again after the 3-year hiatus due to COVID. I think they've really gone the extra mile this year to make it a great, great event. So Marianne van der Steen is now up for the women's semi-finals. Another climber who's been around for many, many years. Has a lot of experience, very strong climber. Years old. Her goal this year, she said, is to win the European Cup and reach the podium in the World Tour. So let's see how she gets on. A very strong climber. She describes her weakness, though, as a mental state. Sometimes the voice of doubt can get in there, and that's something that she has to work on, overcoming those insecurities to be in the right mental frame of mind. It's so important. Doesn't matter how strong you are, how many pull-ups you can do, or how long you can dead hang. None of those matter if you're not in the right headspace. And there's a difference between being a strong climber and a strong competition climber. You have to be able to perform on the day. When you've got the nerves, maybe you've got jet lag, maybe you're in the wrong kit, as we just saw with Luna Ladevant. That happens, thankfully, very, very rarely. But you've got to perform on the day. That is part of the sport. She's looking very comfortable, Marianne. Just taking her time. She's previously come second overall on the European World Tour in 2018 and 2020, but the gold does elude her. We saw her as well in Sasfe last year, as she placed eighth in the final. Matches with the right hand there to get that second position on her tool. She's someone who's climbing all year round with her husband Dennis van Hoek. Now we're over to the men, and this looks, if I'm not mistaken, rather like Mohammad Reza Safdarian, all the way from Iran. He's another climber who's been really a legend of the sport. He's been around for several years. And equally dangerous both in lead and speed. Big star back in his home country as well. He's just looked like he's made easy work of the first ice barrel. On to get off this second one. Oh, so carefully you've got to be to get off. Big reach there for Razor. He's doesn't have the longest reach. It's actually quite, he's not the tallest. Let's put it like that. Height isn't always an advantage. Razor's been competing for 8 years on the World Tour. And narrowly missed out on the overall title in 2020. Went into Sasfe in the lead, but then flunked in the qualifiers. Back to Marianne van der Steen. So the high point set by Yunsun Shin is 13.29. That's quick draw number 13 and move number 29. Mariana, of course, doesn't need to beat that. This being just the semis, but she needs to get into the top eight. And if she's able to continue like this, it should be possible, but don't wish to tempt fate, because it can always go wrong. That is the nature of this sport. It's very unforgiving. Gets that left hold. Now, what's she doing with that left leg? I thought she was trying to go into the fig nine there for a second. Struggling a little bit. No, she's off. Looked like the ran out of time there. So, Mohammad Reza Safdarian, his route has finished as well. So the next male to go up will be Yoon Kyu Park. Here's Mariana, allows herself a smile. Tries to undo the figure of eight knot. Oh, that can be actually the hardest challenge of the whole thing. You've had a little bit of pump, and when you've weighted the rope, it can be very, very tight. Quite hard to undo. Thank you. Nice to see you thanking the B layers. We do a great job. That's the semis for Mariana. Next up in the women will be Petra Klingler. And then in the men, the Korean athlete Joon Kyu Park. Just waiting for them to come out from isolation, and then they have 60 seconds to get climbing. Here she is, Petra. Mentioned earlier, she recently teamed up with Luna Ladovo on an event called Red Bull Dual Ascent, which was a novel format, seeing climbers from all disciplines, bouldering, competition climbing, ice climbing, come together on a massive dam. Petra is a multi-discipline climber, one of the most experienced females in the whole lineup here. Of course, she's the bouldering world champion from 2016. And actually, she's really concentrating on the bouldering at the moment. She said she's only picked up a pair of tools in December, but that usually doesn't stop her. She was very late in picking up some tools. I seem to remember last year didn't stop her from winning Sass Fay, the World Championships last year. You can just see it in the way she moves, the efficiency, the precision, knowing where to place the tool. Something that you see the pros do, unlike kind of amateurs or beginners, is it's all about the placing of the pick. Something that beginners to dry tooling often do is they think that the hold is the hand, and it's not. It's the pick, and it's really thinking about that tool as an extension of your hand. Something Luna also talks about, what he loves about the sport, is having that feeling that your arm is extended. Those tools are a part of you. So Petra is romping up the first section of this route. Not sure that's an official climbing term, but she is sending it so far. Moves down into the Stein. Matches it with the right. Now reaches up to get that high hold. Kind of mix of holds that we see here in Korea, mostly of the sort of plastic resin type. Some of them will have a little metal disc, a little sweet spot in the middle. Difficult to see exactly, even difficult when you're on the route, as Petra has a closer inspection there, just to check the pick is in the right spot. Now, if you want to get good at this sport, just look at the pick position and just see how it doesn't move while the athletes climb up through the move. So here is Korean Ajung Kyu Park. He's 25 years old. He did compete in Cheongsong 3 years ago. Came 21st. Otherwise, not much on the World Tour database of him. So he's on the ice part of the route. Most competition, certainly on the World Tour, routes feature real ice. It's an integral part of the sport. I'm just wondering if he's missed that draw. He needs to clip that hanging quick draw. And is he going to get it? He does. You have to clip every quick draw. If you miss one out, that's too bad. That becomes your score will be the last one that you clip correctly in sequence. Clipping the draws is really an integral part of the scoring system. Not so much integral as premier. It's the most important part of the scoring system. Just allows himself a little blow. Not sure what that was for. Clear away perhaps a little bit of ice. So Petra. Petra moves now into this rather awkward of moves. Steeply overhanging. Gives herself a shake. Looks down. Now figure of four. Getting big shouts from below. Strength, endurance here is required. Doesn't get it on the first go. Gets that hold on the second go. It's a question she is wondering. Gets the feet over. She trusts it. Matches now with the right tool. And then releases that tool. That allows a little bit of a shake now to reach up with the right. This is where we saw Mariana struggle a little bit. Gets high in that fig four, and she should be able to reach up high now with the right. She does. Can she get those feet in? We want to get that draw and just move up through this overhang as quickly as she can. Nice. She just uses her palm for balance there. That pick hold is obviously super solid. Matches with the right. Oh no, she's off. It's possible that was the clock. It's difficult to see the time. It's not something we have here in the commentary box. No, Petra. The scoreboards are updated. Now she has moved into the highest position, so her place in the finals is almost certainly secured. It's enough to get her into the final. Great news there. Great performance for Petra Klingler. She now has the chance to relax, try and do a bit of recovery, get her strength back before the finals tomorrow. Thank you. All kicks off tomorrow with a speed final at 10 a.m. Korea time. And then the lead final is at 1:30 p.m. on Sunday. So if you're in Europe, that's an early start or a late night, depending. But wherever you are in the world, hope you're watching and enjoying all the action here from Cheongsong, Korea. So we have Youngjung Lee here, another star Korean performer, 29 years old. And he won the last weekend's national championships. So definitely on form. So he'll be looking to repeat his performance from a few years ago where he came third in Cheongsong in 2019. Didn't do quite so well the following year, 2020 came 12th. But as I said, Lee is on form and currently in great condition. High point achieved by the men was that from Luna Ladon, his performance. He got to the top, but he wasn't able to top. He wasn't able to stick the hold. He came off on the final dyno. But he currently leads the rankings with Mohammad Reza Safdarian in second and Yonghae Kwon in third place in the rankings for the final. So, Youngjung Lee, it's all about his performance now. Nothing is a given in this sport. Very confident placing of tool there. The reverse grip, not as quite secure when the head is not flush against the gets over straight onto the first of the ice barrels. Gets that quick draw. fig four, fig nine. Just to kind of sequence through the moves here to get across. And important not to forget those quick draws. A little bit of swing there. He'll want to try to get that kind of swinging from side to side a little bit more under control. Not optimum before going for a big reach. He's got to reach up for that bright yellow disc. Hasn't quite got the height. Can he just stand up a little bit on that left foot? Yes, he can. He can. Gives him the height he needs. Careful with the feet now. The reach is for this Stein hold, and it's good. Nicely done from Yongjun Lee. Shake of the left arm. Gets that next hold with the side hang. Where the pick is flush to the wall, moves up the hands through the positions and allows him to reach out left with that left arm matches with the right. Now this is Eni Bertling from Finland, and she's already at the roof. She goes that reverse grip on that side hang, that moving through, gets herself onto the figure nine. Little bit of, oh no, and she's off. Difficult to know exactly what happened there with Eni. Have to wait and see to learn if it's enough to get her to qualify for the finals. That score will come up shortly. You can always, if you're watching live, you can see the results, uiaa.results.info. So Yongjun Lee now, the clock is counting down, and you can hear his teammates shouting for him below. It sounds like all 30 of them are there. Next draw is in sight. He's not far from top of the route here. Just got to get through these volumes. Oh, he did very well to stay on there. This is where you're rushing a little bit, make mistakes, and you come off. That's exactly what happened. He's just trying to speed up in those last few moves just to get as high, just a little bit higher. But his result hasn't quite come up. Just seeing any what happened with her. Let's see where she, what score she gets. She got a score of 10.22. Currently puts her in seventh place, but still with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more women to come. So it's not looking great for any to get into the finals, but let's see. Lee getting a little bit of help here to get him off the rope. So next Korean athlete will be Minchul Kim. But first now we're looking at the women, and it looks like Emir McSwiggan, all the way from Ireland. Although she's lived in Korea for a number of years, so she'll be very familiar with the style of the route, with the style of climbing and the types of holds. She's not in perfect condition. Back in the days a few years ago when she was training all the time and super strong, she let on that she's had a little bit of an issue with her intercostal muscle. That's one of the ones that goes in the ribs. And she was laughing as she told me, actually. She said that the doctor had sort of said, as all doctors do when you have any kind of injury, oh, don't do any exercise for a month or so. And that was 5 days ago. Doesn't look like it's holding her back in any way. Amazing to see some of the athletes do climb through extraordinary pain. I'm reminded of Stina Gerber a few years ago and still got to the podium with bruised ribs. Quite a common injury, actually. But Eamon McSwiggin here, looking like she hasn't lost any of that famous strength. Just taking her time, making sure she doesn't make any mistakes, making sure each hold is really positive. So this is actually her 10th year competing in Cheongsong. First competed in 2013. That next quick draw. A few tests, physical test, and then it was a quick look as well. Very subtle, that you see athletes do just before she went into that, the figure of four. You kind of wait the pick, sometimes have a quick look. Often you'll see athletes just wobble it, wiggle it a little bit left and right, up and down. Yeah, she's just searching for that sweet spot. Usually it's a little divot, maybe a little sweet spot within the hold. Looks just to check. This is really nice climbing from Uma McSwiggin. She's looking very confident. Not 100% with that hold on the volume. Difficult to see. And of course, it would have been difficult to see during observation as well. So it's really important that you take your time, get it right. Mistakes are very, very costly. She was 12th in Cheongsong from a few years ago. But now we're back, we're looking back at the men. And this is Min Kyo Kim. 33 years old, and he was 10th last time he performed here in 2020, but didn't quite make the finals, so he'll be looking to change that. Back to Ema. Ema is one of the 11 athletes who topped both routes in qualification. She moves now onto this horizontal ice barrel. Both male and female athletes on the ice barrel. A lot of the athletes are leaving it too late to get that quick draw. They're often forgetting about it. He's done well to catch it and clip it. Look suspiciously close to a aid. You're not allowed to use any kind of artificial aid. And he held onto it quite tightly. Hopefully he won't receive any penalty for that. It's obviously, it's important to clip the draw, and sometimes you've got to hold it pretty tightly. Maybe it's like the Tour de France, where you have sticky buckle, a little bit of a sticky quick draw. Again, this one looking just almost out of reach. But he's got it. So this is where he needs to dig deep, get into the right position, get his foot, get his crampon points into that ice. And it's just skated off. It's not in place. But he's hoping it's enough. He's got enough height on the move to make it. He's not. He's going to try and fight now with that right foot to get the crampon points into the ice. Unfortunately, seems to have run a little bit out of puff. He's a little bit pumped now, struggling. Big shouts from below, willing him on. Can he do it? Can he get that hold? One last little effort to get the feet in the right place before going for it. Now he's moved him out of the place. It's not looking good. Not looking good. He's going back all over again, starting off into figure of four, shuffling round to get that right foot into position. He's fighting. He's not giving up. The clock is ticking on Kim here. Now, can he try again? Struggling. Just got to keep that left foot in the ice and try and stand up on it. No, he's going for figure of four. In truth, it looks like he doesn't know what he's trying to do. He hasn't decided the optimum technique, and he just hangs on until he can no longer hang on. Gravity eventually won that battle. But Ema continues, just seeing the replay here of Minjil Kim. Back with Ema. No, the women has moved on. Ema is off, and we're now looking at Moon Hwa Jeong. So she's actually one of the oldest competitors here, 52 years old. It makes her 30 years older than some of the young athletes coming through on the team. It just goes to show that it's a sport that you can do at all ages and still be in great form, even for decades. Certainly you wouldn't notice it looking at her move here. Of course, the age with age comes experience, and that counts for a lot. She's going into that figure of four. Get that next hold. Currently, Eni Bertling is in eighth place. That is the mark to beat. And that, and Eni's high point was quick draw number 10, move number 22. There's still some way to go for Jeong. She's certainly got the experience. Familiar face on the Korean national team. Quite often podiums in the national events. Gets that Stein with the right, moves the feet over. reaches up, gets that next quick draw. Reaches up high, doesn't get it with a first attempt. Quite a strenuous movement, although the stein is pretty solid. You know, it is quite strenuous, and you don't want to be doing that upward movement too many times. You got it on the second go. She's moving into figure of four just for a bit more stability to get that right. Did well to hold it. The pick just wobbled a little bit, quite left and right. It's quite close. Now she matches both tools there. She's going to pull herself up, have another look. She's reaching up now to get that rather hidden hold on the volume. A little bit of movement, but just goes to show that when you get the pick in the right spot, so often they do tolerate a little bit of movement. Provided that, of course, is in exactly that right place within the hold. Managing to maintain that pick position, even when she moves up with the feet, that's so important. Gets that next big move. Here's where the difficulties really begin. Traversing over onto the ice barrel. Nerve-wracking stuff. Here, as she makes it over onto the ice barrel. Wunwai Zhong making her way underneath the roof. Climbers often talk about this this feeling of being three-dimensional, and definitely the route here on the structure here in Cheongsong, you get that feeling up here at this point where it's very three-dimensional. You're kind of almost in space, operating upside down. You're not really on anything fixed. You're just going through those moves. Exposure all around you. And Jiong is still looking good. She's made it through this roof section. This is where it gets a little bit delicate. We've seen a lot of athletes come unstuck here. If she does fail here, it won't be through lack of shouting from her teammates below. It looks as though that is the clock timing out. I was switching directly to the men. And this looks like the Japanese climber, Gehado Gadota. Excuse me. It looks like it's Jijun Ling. No, it is. Excuse me. So again, Gehado Gadota, the Japanese climber. Just checking the number there. Is one of Japan's top climbers. ...34 years old. Now he's at one of the cruxes of this route. getting off this barrel of ice. Very technical. Where we saw Kim just a few minutes ago, really struggling. Now it's Kadota going to do it. He's finding it equally hard. You just got the movement of the barrel swinging. You can't really get the feet in. It's difficult. Didn't manage to get the semis, the finals 3 years ago. Can he get the semis this year? Got to make this move. Is he going to commit to it? Ah, oh, and he's off. So that is over for Yahado Gatota. And now it's back to the women, Jung Min Kim. And she was 18th in 2020 in Cheongsong. So already improved on that performance just to making the semi-finals. Just going to have a look on the men's results to see the score from Kadota, where that puts him. Puts him in ninth place, which is unfortunately not enough to get into the final. So Jungmin Kim, another, should we say, senior member of Team Korea. She's 46 years old. She came 15th in SASFE. So, no stranger to high-level competition. So far, looking really strong. And it's not looking like the rain is putting off any athletes. Of course, being on the overhanging section, they are a little bit more sheltered than some of the judges and belayers. All the spotlight is on her. Still three more female athletes to come through. That's Olga Kosek, Catalina Shirley and Sina Gertz, who are all top performers. Kim did top both routes in qualification yesterday. Very strong, self-assured climber. Still trying to get higher, a little bit higher on the leaderboard, a little bit higher on the route to earn her place in the finals. High point now, eighth place, is set by the Iranian climber Shabnam Asadi, 10:22. It's the 10th quick draw. Move number 22. She needs to get a little bit higher up to secure that spot. Still, she's fighting. Still, some way to go, though. You need to be able to move quickly and efficiently through these These moves, the clock is ticking. The timer only counts in the event of a tie if you top, but otherwise it's there in the background. You don't have unlimited time to get as high as you can. Well, there was a question earlier whether some of the athletes might be a little bit rusty, having not been doing any top flight competition for a few years, but I think we can safely say that is not the case. The standard, not just from Kim here, but all athletes really is showing signs of climbing on top performance, really seeing them looking strong. Getting through that first awkward traverse on those side hangs. Oh, and she's off. Wasn't quite able to hang in there. So 007 here, who is that? Looks like the American climber, Keenan Griscom, one of the upcoming talents of Team USA. Only 18 years old, burst onto the youth scene a couple of years ago, came second in Russia. And then he won the youth the following season. Really strong climber. He says, the more fun I'm having, the better I climb. So let's hope he's having a blast here. Just missed that draw. Is he going to have to get it with the tool? It'll be really costly if you forget the draw. He's just going to change positions. He topped both routes in qualification. Looking really strong. Been climbing since the age of 5. Already has a lot of experience under his belt. So just comparing the way he's moving through these moves compared to those last Korean climbers, Keenan's looking really quite confident, self-assured, and a potential contender in tomorrow's final. But almost certainly now, just get above here, go through into the finals with this performance. Could we see him challenge the likes of Luna Ladovov? That's possibly a question that Luna will be wondering himself. And he's got that strength, that stability in the core to hold his position. Didn't manage to get the quick draw though. Just a little bit of time. Keenan is psyched to do the full season, so we'll see him next weekend in Champagne, and then the weekend after in Saas-Fee. 3 back-to-back World Tour stops. We've also got on the European Cup circuit, we've got Oulu and Glasgow for the first time hosting an official UIAA European Tour stop coming up in the season. So definitely save the dates. Keenan looking really strong here. Difficult to know what the clock is doing. Still he climbs. No one has yet topped the route. Oh no, and he's off. Tempted fate. So Olga Kosek now straight over to her, 31-year-old Polish climber who's been competing since 2014. She won the European Cup in 2021. She's most proud, though, of her fourth place in the European Championships in Oulu in last year in 2022. So, looks like she's yet to get to the overhanging section. Olga's a very strong all-round climber, doesn't just climb competitions. She's also put up first ascents in the Tatra Mountains of Poland. Her strength is her mind, she says. Very strong mind, as you would expect from a top level competition pilot and anyone who climbs at a high level outdoors, where your mind is so key. Oh, she just took that really confidently, just stood up and picked, just sat effortlessly in the right place. And that's what you want at this elite level, a reminder that these are the world's best competition ice climbers out there. And so much of it comes down to getting that pick in the right place, moving quickly through the moves, getting the pick quickly on the move. And she's just fishing around. She looks like she can't see exactly, so it's a little bit of a case of feeling with the pick, holding it in that position. Just look at the pick. The pick won't move position as she changes hands, and whether she, as she gets higher in the move. There we are. Look, still that pick stays in the same place. That were a beginner climber for sure, that pick would have probably ripped by now. And that's just showing what they do at the top end, able to keep that stability in the placement. That really is the challenge of the sport. At least one of them. One of the many. Strength also helps. Anaerobic strength, monstrous anaerobic strength in the forearms is also a big advantage. Having a strong core, really good hip flexibility. There are very few parts that this sport doesn't touch. Having a strong head. As for weaknesses, well, Olga says rather cheekily on her form, on the survey we sent to all athletes, that she doesn't have any. So she gets that hold, moves into the figure of nine, changes positions with the hands, takes the position number two on the tools. Now, there are three positions on the tools, most for most athletes. This looks like Tristan Ludovan, a Ladovan. A little bit of a mashup of Luna and Ladovan. They kind of are, they come together, these two, Tristan and his brother Luna. Both of them say that the high point was SAS Bay last year, with Luna on the number one place and Tristan here coming third. They both stood on the podium. They do a lot of climbing together, and really they come as a unit. A reminder that their gear didn't turn up. So Tristan here is on borrowed kit. Let's hope that it's working well for him. One of his weaknesses, he said, is his speed. He needs to speed up his climbing. But it's not looking too slow here. So the high point he needs to get to is quick draw number 11. Move number 21, set by Jun Q Park, currently lying in eighth place in the men's. But so far, Tristan looking pretty competent and confident as he gets through these ice bollards. His brother still stays in the top stop. And he's just looking at the draws. Has he missed one out? He's just realized that he has, and he needs to go back and get it. This has caught quite a few athletes. Got to get the draws. If you miss one out, your score will not progress. Catches it, gets it very, very efficiently there. Didn't waste too much time. But he'll be looking to get a swift move on now onto this bollard. This has really proved quite tricky for many athletes. It's all about getting that crampon point into the ice that gives you the stability you need, platform from which you can stand up a little bit in the move and reach that disc hold. He's just having one last hold. He's just standing so delicately. Can he do it? One last look. Goes for the draw first. Important to get the points. It's the draw that gives you the score. That's your primary score, is the quick draw number. Now, releases the right. Doesn't quite have the height. Just inches with his feet. Very difficult, very different as well to competition sport climbing, where you don't have the same ankle flexibility. You can't stand up on your toes in the way that you can in a pair of rock shoes. You have the degrees of movement with a crampon on the end of your toe is much, much less. Normally your heel needs to be 90 degrees to the wall for the optimum position. Oh, Tristan Ladevant showing us how it's done. Still looking really strong here, with a performance that should get him through into the final tomorrow. A reminder, those finals begin at 10 a.m. with the speed finals. Big shouts from the crowd below now. There's the 22-year-old Tristan Ladevant from France. Works through the moves on this upper section of the route here in Cheongsong. First stop, the UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup Tour. Just seems to be getting stronger. Moving very quickly now. He'll be looking to see if he can match his brother. Gets that right pick into the spot. Is that time? Time is out for Tristan Ladevant. With a performance that should almost guarantee him a place into the finals. We'll know soon enough when the scores are updated. But for now, it's back to the women. And we're looking at the American climber, Catalina Shirley, who's another upcoming star of Team USA. Just 20 years old. But she won the lead and speed at UIAA last year. And also came 14th. In SASFE in the World Championships, didn't quite make the finals. So we'll see whether she can make the finals today here in Cheongsong. So Tristan Ladevant, just to update you, has moved into joint third place with Keenan Griscom. So in the event of a tie, it's the count back procedure is used. So whoever had the highest score in qualifiers will be ranked the higher as they go into the final. But let's see how Catalina Shirley is doing here. She'll be looking with this performance to book her place into female final tomorrow. Still some way to go for her. Really exciting to see the emerging talent come through in Team USA. Team has only really come on in the last few years. We're seeing a lot of new names come through now. And it seems as though they're taking the sport a lot more seriously, a lot more dedicated training, a lot more effort going into developing the sport in the US. And Catalina is one of the rising stars. Been climbing since the age of 14. And that's dry tooling, was climbing before then. Now she'll be looking forward to this. She says her favorite move is a figure of four. So she will be feeling more confident as she goes into fig four. So confidence climber when it gets overhanging and there's nowhere for the feet. Can't quite see what's happening behind. Oh no, and she's off. So that will be disappointing for her, but let's see if it's enough to get her through to the finals. Always disappointing to peel off. So, our French athlete here, Virgile Devin. Another very, very strong climber who's come on in the last few years. He's 22 years old. Also mates with the Swiss climber Benjamin Bossard. They teamed up last year. Did a bit of climbing together in the Alps. And they did the super cool work. Mont Blanc to tackle. The Virgin has been around for the last few years, one of the French climbers from Grenoble. And he was last year's overall winner on the European Cup. So can he replicate that success on the World Tour? That's the question for him today. So far, he's looking pretty strong. Remembered the quick draw. Gotta make sure he doesn't miss the other one that's just on the other side. There we are. Just above him. Now, gets that tool into that second barrel of ice, which has been the scene of so many athletes coming unstuck, and he's going very early now. Maybe thinks to get himself in a better position, get that foot in place. Remember that he won't have seen how any of the other athletes took this. They've all come from isolation. So it's to ensure no one has an advantage. He's got a long reach and he's been able to get that next hold. He's super careful here. There's quite a lot of swing going on in that barrel to get that next draw and the next hold into that stein, and he's got it. Deploys the guns, formidable upper arm strength and back strength. Gets the stein up into that next hold, which is a side hang. Moves his hand up the shaft of the axe. It's a little bit higher. Now into fig four, stabilizes the pick. That's one reason to do the fig four. Just keeps it nicely weighted. in the hold, giving you a little bit more freedom, a little bit more height, a little bit more security, make the next move. Not a fan of the metal holds, Virgil Devant. But he says he likes the figure of fours. He's strong on them. So this is definitely finalist territory. Just reaches up with the hand just to feel it. Find a little sweet spot. Perhaps a hold. Wouldn't have been able to have seen or had a close look on in observation. Sometimes you'll see athletes actually take the hold with the hand, particularly those with a strong rock climbing background, but not today. Gets into that fig four and really gets so much higher in the zone. It's not quite high enough to reach and get that next hold. A big, big reach, jumps up. Difficult. He's got to make sure the pick stays in that position. He's got to keep it weighted down. Moves up through it, it will ping off. And he can't afford too many attempts. With each attempt, he hemorrhages energy. Can he get it? He's got it. He's got it. Gets the feet in. Matches with the right hand into that second position. Now has both tools matching in the same hold. Shake, quick shake of the right. Reaches out to the right now. Traverses over. Does well just to keep the tension on that right hand tool, which is now in the left hand, freeing the right hand to get the next hold on this next volume. Reverse grip into what looks like a floating underkilling, not quite a stein, it's a little bit more unstable. Oh, it's off! It wobbled, I thought it was going to stay, and it didn't. He just shuffled a little bit through the move, and he came off. A great performance there from Virgil Devant, which will almost certainly get him through into the finals. So we were looking at Olga Kosek. I think she has come off now. This looks like Sina Gertz, who is the last female athlete in the semis. She is just after Catalina Scherny. Let's have a look at the rankings at the moment, just on the quick score sheet. So, Catalina Scherny is in joint eighth place at the moment, with joint seventh place with Olga Kosek. We're getting to 11th quick draw, and move number 23 was their score. So that is where Sina needs to get to. Get above. And she is one of the strongest female athletes in the circuit, been around for several years, even though she's still only 23 years old. But she's been dry tooling since the age of 14. Been competing since 2015. Here on the World Tour, so already a massive veteran. And it shows with this level of competence and efficiency. Sad for her that she wasn't able to compete in her hometown of Sasfe last year. She got COVID just before, so she missed out last year. ...2020 was last full season that she competed. And what a season it was for her. She won every European Tour stop. She came second in Sasfe, behind only Maria Polokonina. Tina Gertz moving strongly through. She's off. Difficult to know whether that was the clock. It looked like the clock ran out then. And that, Sina was the last of the 16 women to go through in the semi-finals. So hopefully we'll see a leaderboard come up shortly. Still in the men, though, we've got two more athletes to come. We've got John Clark and Benjamin Brossard. We're just waiting for Athena, moves into third place there. Third highest score, 13-28. So her place in the finals is secure. So she'll be hoping for now a good night's rest, good recovery food for the showdown tomorrow afternoon. A reminder when that all is taking place. We have at 10 o'clock local time in Korea, we have the speed finals kicking off, and then the lead finals is at 1:30 local time at the Cheongsong Ice Valley Ice Climbing World Cup Stadium. It's been hosting since 2011, and it's so great to be back here, one of the best structures on the world tour. So Hyung Park, the local Korean star, an absolute legend of the sport, and one of the greats of the men, really. And it shows with the way he climbs. He didn't win the national championships the other day, interestingly. I think they were told that there was a technicality. But absolutely, he looks on fire here, really on form. Look at that, the way he just gives that a really good wobble just to make sure the pick is sitting in the right spot. He's not just a competition climber, he's also a really solid alpinist. He's made first ascents, he's climbed Trango Tower, been on expeditions in Alaska. And here he is at his national stadium of Cheongsong, looking to earn his place into tomorrow's finals. He is three-time winner of the World Tour, 2011, 2013 and 27. And he's got those tattooed on his left arm. Shows you how proud he is of those victories. Are we going to see 2023 as another tattoo? That is perhaps a distant hope for Korean. He's now in his 40th year. At least he'll be familiar with some of the route, with some of the holds, which he has made himself. He makes holds himself. He's got his own gym as well. So there's definitely a home advantage for Hyung Park. Now he moves on to the ice. Let's see how the Ice King takes them. He'll pull up just to have a look. Little look-see to ensure the pick is in the right place and it doesn't go out of bounds into the red zone. Quick reminder that after Hyung, we still have one more male athlete, the 17th climber, Benjamin Brossard from Switzerland. So, Hyung not forgetting the quick draws like other athletes have done. Here we come to really what's, I think, is the crux of the route. And he gets his feet on and then into figure of four. such a strong climber, Hyeong. Really just, that's the textbook way to take this hold. Ooh, lost his feet, but it didn't matter because that pick is in such a strong place. Now to get the quick draw, delicate work. You saw the way he just looped it first over his thumb, just caught it just to take a little bit of slack. And then very nicely done, just swinging the legs onto the roof, into the plywood, which I mentioned earlier has all replaced all new paneling throughout the structure this season. It's going to be a great showdown, the finals tomorrow. Both, we got the Lunar Ladavant. We're going to have Mohamed Reza Safdarian and Tristan Ladavant. And almost certainly Hyeong Park. We'll get into it with this performance. Good mix of nationalities. French, Korean, American, and Iran. To the left, to the right, to the left again. Just make sure that his tool is placed correctly. And then hold that tension. That's just a quick shake of the left hand to get just how important that grip strength is. You don't want to grip too tightly. Needs to be strong enough to hold, but you don't want to just knock yourself out. Really using a lot of tension just to hold this position. Really good core strength here from Hyeong Park. Moving up now towards the upper section of the route. Big reach there. With a little bit of a check. Looks out, taking no chances. So Hyeong does have a point to prove this season. Crashed out in 2020. So just to make the finals will be a result for him. The clock though is counting down now. Needs to get as high as he can. Only Lunar Ladavant so far has managed to get to the top, but no one has got to the top, and Hyeong Park doesn't get there either. It looks like the clock ran out on him too. But with that performance, that should be enough to earn his place into the final. Let's see. The scores have just been updated, and it's... the. Not yet updated, so we'll wait for that to come through. Next athlete will be Benjamin Bossard. So Hyeong Park there. Here we go, he moves into third place, yes. That gets him certainly a place in tomorrow's finals. So job well done for him, he'll be happy. That will be, depending on where Benjamin Bossard finishes up. And if he qualifies, that will mean that the starting order of tomorrow's final will be in descending order. So that will mean he'll be third last to go up to start his final route. You'll see it's raining here in Cheongsong. Not the perfect conditions that we'd like for the competition, but unfortunately we're not have no control of the weather. So we're now just waiting for the final male athlete to come through, Benjamin Bossard from Switzerland. And here he is. He now has a minute to begin his route. Got the headphones just coming out. Bossard is still only 19 years old. Another rising star. He came second in last year's World Championships in Sasfe. He was second earlier this season in Brno. And his route has begun. He has 6 minutes to get higher than Yonghae Kwon, who's currently lying in eighth place. That means getting beyond the 14th hold. Mentioned earlier, he's mates with Virgil Devin. They've been climbing together in the Alps. I think you'll find some real friendships are forged here on the competition circuit. And one of the athletes told me actually a couple of days ago that they were struggling to get into the competitive spirit because they're just so happy to see so many of their friends from the tour. It's been the first time really, first time here in Korea for 3 years. And for many athletes, first time we've seen each other for a long, long time. And perhaps a bit too pleased to just be here and have fun and hang out. And they were joking that it will be hard to get into that competitive mind spirit. But it looks as though Benjamin Bossard has not had difficulty finding that headspace he needs to compete at the very, very best. At this early section, it looks like he's really flashing this. That left-hand tool looks like it's just glued where it is. There we are. Confidently goes up with the right. Very, very quick with the hands, both in reaching up, finding the hold, placing them, committing to the move, moving the feet. Just every element of the movement has just sort of efficiency. He's just had a good look there. Got great flexibility. Into fig nine. Gets the next tool placement into the fig four. He's able to release that first place tool. Left a little bit behind to a little late to get that quick draw, but there's been no too much of a problem. Now to the second barrel of ice. Doesn't get it on the first go, but on the second. He's still looking really, really strong here, Benjamin. Definitely, if I'm one of the other finalists, I would be have this man at the back of my mind as a very, very dangerous threat. No, he's got his feet in a good position. Is he just going to stand up? No fig four for him. No, it is a little bit harder than at first it seems. Oh, and he's off. No. Committed to not really so much a dyno move, but committed to standing up and just didn't get it. So it'd be good to see if we're going to get a replay of him, but we're looking at Sina Gertz here. So in a moment, we'll hopefully see exactly what happened. That's Yong Park. So not sure if that will be enough to get Benjamin Bossard into the final. And looking at the men's results, it doesn't look as though that is enough to get him through. Leaves him in 15th place. So he will have a little bit of disappointment there with that result. But otherwise, great performance there from the Swiss athlete. So as soon as the leaderboard comes up, we will discuss, find out who will make the finals for tomorrow, which happen at 1:30 local time. Just a final look at the structure there. Waiting for the leaderboard. If they don't come up, I'll just read them out. So, welcome to the opening round of the UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup, live from the beautiful city of Cheongsong. Nestled among the Taebaek Mountains, the city is surrounded by national parks and adventurous activities. But Cheongsong is more than just a destination for thrill seekers. The city is also home to a number of cultural and historical attractions. With its stunning natural beauty and rich cultural heritage, Cheongsong is a place that has something for everyone. This season, we have three World Cups from Cheongsong, Champigny-en-Vanoise, and Sasse Bay over 3 weeks. So it's going to be a real test of the athletes' endurance as well as their skill.